Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I'm going to do kind of a comparison video again with this polish that I'm currently wearing on my nails right now. This is Lollipop Posse Lacquer and this is Apples Cherries. I purchased this back in 2020 kind of to replace my Polish for Days Long Live the King. If you've been with me for a while or follow me on Instagram, you may know that I had Long Live the King, and while it is a beautiful polish, I did not like it on me for the simple fact that it was an orange leaning red, and what I wanted was a red. I know it's very hard to get a red that I'm looking for with these kinds of warm, beautiful flakies, but this one called to me a little bit more than Long Live the King did. So I purchased it, but I haven't worn it until this year, 2021. And actually last night while I was painting my nails. So this polish I wore last night, I painted my nails last night, and it's already had some tip wear because I have been cooking and cleaning, and so obviously, you know, you guys know how it is. You live your life, you get tip wear. But while I was applying this, I was thinking to myself, oh my gosh, this polish reminds me so much of Polish for Days, Seeing is Believing. So I decided to do a comparison with Polish for Days, Seeing is Believing. And as you guys can tell right now, just looking at these bottle shots, they're not even close to similar. I don't know why I thought that this polish was so much like Seeing is Believing. Then I thought, oh, well, maybe it's going to be similar to this Polish for Days, which is Aisling, which I just purchased very recently. And again, I put it next to it, and it isn't a dupe at all. Like, in the bottle, of course. I am going to swatch these because you guys know, in the bottle is not the same as seeing it in actually swatch. But there is one more polish that I want to pull out, and this is Wildflower Lacquer, and this is Darkside of the Moonrise from the Sophisticated Collection. Yeah, I thought about this one because I have a couple of Wildflower Jelly Reds from the Koi Collection because I like to buy the whole collection, and again, it's not similar at all. In fact, I'm going to move this one over here so you guys can see it next to each other. But if you guys look at these polishes, they're not similar at all. However, as I'm painting my nails, all I can think of was this looks like this polish, or this polish. Just in case, by some miracle, these polishes swatch similar, more similar than they are in the bottle, I want to swatch them live for you guys right now. So the first polish is going to be Apples Cherries, from Lollipop Posse Lacquer. And this is the first coat of Apples Cherries. Personally, I put on a visible nail line blurring base coat, and then I put three coats of this polish. I just find it gives my polish more depth. As you guys can see in this first swatch, it's very sheer. It's a jelly. It has to be to showcase all those beautiful flakies. But because of that, I tend to prefer these type of polishes in three coats instead of just two. Next, I'm going to put on Polish for Days, Seeing is Believing, because this one was the first polish I thought of when I was swatching, or excuse me, when I was applying my polish. I will let you guys know that I did also think of Long Live the King. However, I do not have Long Live the King anymore, so I can't do a comparison to them, to that one. However, Long Live the King is more of a red-based or orange-based red, and so in certain angles, this does look like right here, in my angle, I can see that this looks like orangey red, but it's not. This is such a chameleon. Anyways, I'm gonna paint this one next. Here we have, oh yeah, that's not even close to what I thought it was gonna be. Not even close. Wow, guys, look at the difference. I also gotta change that brush on Polish for Days. Wow, that's a big difference. Looks almost purple. Next, I'm going to put on Polish for Days Aisling. I just recently got this and I'm in a pink loving mood. This is actually looking a lot more red on camera than it does in real life. In real life, it is definitely a pink with some gold flakies in there, but it is pink. So this one here, oh yeah, this one has a pinker base than the other ones. Definitely different all around. They are not looking alike at all at this time. And then finally we have Darkside of the Moonrise. And this one is looking a lot more red than pink to my eye, especially after swatching the other three. But I'm going to add it on here. Okay, so I'm going to put it on this side. Oh, I should have put it on the other side. Not as much flaky as it looks like. Alright, so this is all one coat of all of the polishes. I kind of want to put it on this side. I kind of want to put the Wildflower on this side just to compare it with Ashley, and I might do that at the end. So I'm going to let it dry and then do a second coat and a top coat, and then I'll show you guys the final results. Okay guys, so here we have all four of the polishes. So we have Darkside of the Moonrise from Wildflower Lacquer, Polished for Days, Seeing is Believing, Lollipop Posse Lacquer in Apples Cherries, and then we have right here Ashling from Polished for Days. They are not similar at all. I mean, at all. Look at that different. The bases are all different. The flakies that they have are all different. They don't look alike at all, and I don't know what I was thinking when I was applying Apples Cherries on that I thought that these would look the same, but they really, really don't. So as I was editing this video, I realized that I actually have a swatch of Long Live the King that I had swatched from previous when I had Long Live the King. And I wanted to show you guys how different Long Live the King is to Lollipop Posse Lacquer, Apples Cherries, and all the other ones that I have here. It's obviously not the same. It's definitely falls more like warmer, more orangey, like I was explaining earlier on in the video. In real life, I feel like the camera sometimes makes it like washes it out and makes it look very similar, but it really isn't. Like, there's a noticeable difference between these two polishes. And I did do two coats on this one on the swatch stick. So if you have any of the other ones and you were wondering if you want to purchase Apples Cherries, I think you should. I mean, I think that this polish, it's still a little tacky, but I think this polish is like such a chameleon. It really like changes depending on the angle or the lighting situation. I noticed that for me personally, I see some orange red, I see red red, and I see a pink red, depending on the light, depending on the room, depending on how I'm holding my hand. And I've got so many compliments. I received so many compliments while wearing this at work today. It looks so pretty. And even today, even with the tip wear from cooking and cleaning, I still think it looks really beautiful. It's just a beautiful polish. And if you don't have it and you like colors like this, I suggest picking it up. I think it's well worth it. So let me know in the comments down below which polish you have or are interested in getting. I am very interested to know which one attracted you the most. I'm really digging the Ashling from Polish for Days and the Darkside of the Moon, especially because I expected this to be a lot redder than it turned out to be. But I'm very into like pinks right now. So the fact that these two are like really calling to me is no surprise. This is still a pink, but it's definitely more of a darker purpley pink, and these are just like pink, and that's what I'm really gravitating towards right now. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of this video, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.